how this DC generator works that we have seen with the same animation in our previous video. We have also derived the EMF equation for this DC generator. But the question is, what is in this video? So, here in this video, we are going to get relation between terminal voltage and induced EMF in DC shunt generator, and that too using animations. These equations and the approach given in this video will be very much helpful for solving numericals in DC generator and understanding of this machine. So without wasting time, let's get started. Hi, this is Mruduraj and you're watching Learning Vibes. Welcome back to another video on video lecture series of DC generator. So first of all, in this video, we'll try to see cross-sectional view of shunt DC generator, and then we'll understand all the parameters. So this is the shunt filled winding, and the same thing you can observe in our cross-sectional view. So this is how a shunt filled winding is done. With this, the armature winding is connected in parallel, and this is how it is connected in DC shunt generator. The EMF induces in the armature of this DC generator, and what we want to do, we want to establish relation between EMF induced in this armature and the terminal voltage we are getting on the terminals of DC generator. So for this purpose, let's get an equivalent circuit for this diagram or for this DC generator. So here we have the equivalent circuit of this DC generator. So what we have did over here, this armature section is being replaced with the armature resistance and induced EMF E. Now let's get electrical parameters of this circuit. This is the RSH. It is basically the resistance of this shunt filled winding. Then we have this RA. RA is basically the resistance of armature winding that has been placed in this armature. This is a battery, and the voltage of this battery is represented by E, which is basically induced EMF. This EMF basically induces in the armature coil. So this armature coil is being represented with induced EMF E as a DC source and the internal resistance of that coil with RA. Now let's see the other electrical parameters. From this battery, basically IA current flows in this upward direction. Now this IA current is divided into two parts from this junction point. One current will go into shunt filled winding, and that current is known as shunt filled current. The another current will give into the load, and that is known as load current. These are the two terminals of the generator, and the voltage we are getting between these two terminals is known as terminal voltage. So these are the different electrical quantities in shunt DC generator. Now our aim is to establish a relation between induced EMF E and terminal voltage V. It is very simple to establish. We will just apply a KVL over here. But to get this quantity, we need to identify, we need to calculate various quantities like load current and shunt filled current and armature current, right? So for that, first of all, let's have the equation of shunt filled current. So the equation of shunt filled current is ISH is equal to V divided by RSH. And how did we get that? Basically, the terminal voltage we are getting over here, these points and these points are in parallel with terminal. So it is very much obvious that in parallel circuit, the voltage is same. So here we'll use the terminal voltage, and it is the shunt filled resistance. In practical generator, you can measure it using multimeter. Or if you are calculating numericals, then in numerical, shunt filled resistance is already given. So from these two quantities, you can calculate the ISH, shunt filled current. The next quantity is IL, the load current. Majority of the time, if you are talking about practical generators, you can add ammeter over there, and from that ammeter you can get the load current. And if you are solving numericals, then it is possible that either load current is directly given or load power is given, and from that load power you need to calculate the load current. We will see how to solve the numericals of this DC shunt generator, and the link of that video will be provided in description box below or above here in card. You can check out that videos later on. Now we need to find the IA current. So to find IA current, the equation is IA is equal to ISH plus IL, and it is very simple. Now we'll move ahead. We'll go to establish the relation between IE and V. But now, before we jump ahead, I want you to hit that like button. What are you thinking? Just hit that like button. And if you have not subscribed to this channel, just hit that subscribe button, man. Help us in growing our channel. Help us all the students reaching to this type of videos. So please like and subscribe to this video. And if you want to solve numericals, and if you want to attend our live sessions, then you can join our Learning Vibes Learning community. How to join? The link to join that community is given in description box below. There is no single penny charge to join that community. It's completely free for all. Now let's get back to the topic. So if we apply KVL over here, basically what we need to do, just understand this thing. It is very simple. It is the total voltage induces. We need to just subtract this voltage drop from this, and we will get the terminal voltage. So according to this, the equation will be like this. The terminal voltage V is equal to induced EMF E minus IARA drop. So from this simple equation, you can write the equation for induced EMF. E is equal to V plus IARA. Terminal voltage V, armature current and armature resistance. So using this much of quantity, you can calculate the complete numericals of DC shunt generator. So this is the relation between induced EMF E and terminal voltage V. Now it's time for your brain test. I will ask you a single question, and you need to give me the answer of that question in comment section below. The question is, from previous equation, can you tell me the relation between induced EMF and terminal voltage? So you need to think over this question, and you need to write the answer of this question in comment section below. If you can answer this question, that would be great. In next video, we'll be deriving equation for series generator. And if you want to go for another video on DC generator, then you can check out this playlist. I insist at least once you check that playlist. If you want to watch animated videos on specific topic, then write that thing in comment section below, and I'll make animated videos on that topic. So until we meet again in our next video, till the time, bye bye.